Hi children, welcome to the mathematics class. In our last class we have been dealt about the exercise number 1.4. okay, now we are supposed to switch on for the exercise number 1.5. so here in this exercise number 1.5, it is again dealing with the rational and irrational numbers. So in this exercise number 1.5, first main it is to segregate the rational and irrational numbers. Oh, let me go for that. So I read it the question. Here you can see in a textbook. So take a textbook and open the page number 24. So here the first question, what I read is, the first question says that classify the following numbers as rational or irrational. Here which are rational we have to write one side, which are irrational that we have to write one side. So let me write here first the separate columns for that. Okay, the first one I write it as a here rational, and here I write it as a irrational. Okay, as you know, the irrational numbers are going to include in the numbers like. Okay, let me go for the first one. Here they have been given that as first 2 minus root 5. So as you know children, 2 minus root 5. Here the root 5. Do you have any root for the square root of 5? The square root of 5 we cannot get with the product of a 2 same numbers. You can get the square root of 4 as a one of the factor that 2 into 2 is a 4. But the square root of 5 is not a one of the perfect square. So right. So then we write that the first one in the irrational column, that is 2 minus square root of 5. So let me go for the next one. That is 3 plus of square root of 23. It is in one bracket minus 23. I write it as here in the working column. So let me see here, 3 plus of square root of 23 minus square root of 23. Correct na children? So now I want to remove the bracket. So by the time I get as a square root of 23 minus square root of 23. So now you see here the bracket has been removed. So the plus square root of 23 subtracts with the minus square root of 23. I remained with the 3. This 3 is one of the rational number. So rational number means it is in a p by q form. That in nothing is there in the denominator will be 1. So this will be coming in the rational number part. So then that is 3 plus of square root of 23 minus square root of 23. It is which one children? It is the second one. So that also is to be mentioned. Okay. Now I go for the third one. The third one is here. I will write here. That is 2 square root of 7 divided by 7 square root of 7. So as we know, if the same quantities are there in the numerator and denominator, that I can cancel. Correct? Now here square root of 7 and square root of 7 are there in numerator and denominator. So then I remain with the 2 by 7. 2 by 7 is a rational, right? So this comes in the rational number column. That is the third one. That is as 2 square root of 7 divided by 7 square root of 7. Okay. So let me go for the fourth one. That is 1 divided by square root of 2. So 1 divided by square root of 2 means square root of 2 is having any perfect factor children? No. So square root of 2 is not having any factor. So that comes under an irrational number, right? 1 divided by square root of 2 only. So it is not having any perfect factors for that. Then let me go for the next one. That is fifth one. That is 2 pi. What is the value of a pi? You know, I think so. That is 3.142 something going on increasing, that which it will not end. So if it is not ending means it is a non-terminating decimal expansion. So if it is non-terminating means that comes under a irrational factor, right? So then the value of it, that is a 2 pi is a one of the irrational number. Understood children? So this is the first main. Now we can go for the second question children. Sorry, second main. Simplify each of the following expressions. What does it mean? We are supposed to simplify means it is given that two datas. We have to simplify means here the product is given means we have to make a product. If it is given a division, whatever the operation is given, that is to be done. Okay, simplify the following. In that the first is 3 plus square root of 3 into 2 plus square root of 2. Here we have to just simplify means what operation is there that we are supposed to do it. So let me take here the two binomial it is. We having a two factors. So let me take here in that 3 outside. So this term I am going to take over here. That is 2 plus square root of 2. So one more I left is plus square root of 3. This also is to be multiplied with this. So I write it once again. That is 2 plus root 2. Okay. So now I need to multiply here as it is having a one term outside and two terms inside. So the next 3 2s are will be the 6. So that I write it as a 6. Then next 3 into this bracket says into square root of 2. Don't do like a 3 into 2 is a 6. No. Why? Because it is there in the square root. It is not having any square root. Here nothing is there means what will be there? 1 will be there. So that 1 into 3 is a 3. So before that plus into plus will be the plus. This 1 into 3 is a 3. Inside here is having a square root 2 as it is. Understood, children? So we go for the next one more. So like that only it is the same case. Here square root of 3 is there. Here square root terms are nothing. Not there. So here nothing is there means what will be there? 1 will be there. So this 1 into 2 is? Yes, 2. Square root of nothing is there here. That will be, if it is there like a 1, that will be again a square root of 3. So the next, nothing is there outside means 1 will be there. Correct, na children? This 1 into nothing is here, a 1. That also will be 1. Plus into plus will be the plus. Square root of 3 into square root of 2. You both are in the square root, right? That all are the, both the terms are inside. So 3 2s will be 6. That comes under a square root only. That is square root of 6. Understood, children? Like this, the value is coming. What is that? 6 plus 3 root 2 plus 2 square root of 3 plus square root of 6. Whatever is there inside the square root, that should be written in a, and it should be multiplied inside the square root. If it is outside terms, that outside terms should be multiplied. Understood, children? Okay, children, we can go for the next. That is the second one. 3 plus square root of 3 into 3 minus square root of 3. Here now, just check it out, children. Here it is one of the form. I am going to show you. It is here. I think it has a. Okay. Plus, this one is a one more, right? That will be a b. So, I want to take this as a plus b. The value of a is 3. Here the value of a is, sorry, one more is 3 only. So that I can take it as a. Then here the value of b is square root of 3. Here is also square root of 3. That I can mention it as a b. Here middle what is there? Minus is there. So it is a minus b. It is a plus b. A plus b into a minus b is what? You know the formula in your previous grade. What is that? That will be a square minus b square. Correct, children? So now instead of this a plus b into a minus b, I can take this as a square minus b square. According to that, it should not be written. It should be, it can be written in the working column. So according to this, I want to write a value I have taken as a 3. Correct, na children? A square is there. A value I have taken as a 3. So I can mention here as a 3 square. Okay. So if I mention here as a 3 square, then minus is there. I want to put that as a minus. The b value I have taken as a square root of 3. So then square root of a 3, it is a b, but it is squared. So I can show it as a squared. Okay. So then 3 square is 9 minus as it is outside square root and the 2 gets cancelled. Or else one more step is there that I can write it as a 3. Square root means its value will be 1 divided by 2. Okay, square root means its value will be 1 divided by 2. That's the power is 2. So the next that I can get as 2 minus of 3. The power into power, I can multiply here as a 1 by 2 into 2. So 2 ones are gets cancelled. So I remained it here with a 3 to the power 1. So the next 3 to the power 1 will be 3. Sorry, 9 minus 3. The value is 9 minus 3 is 6. Okay, so total value of this it is 6. Understood, children? This is the second problem. In this second problem I said, no. So check it out, children. This can be done as usual how I have done in the first problem with the same case. But we have identities, no? That identities have to be used. If that makes a very good impression to the evaluators. Okay. So the two problems are got over. So rest of them can be seen in the next class. Okay, children, for any doubts, you can call and contact me. Okay, bye-bye.